Hey everyone, Kate Fora and Fiona Pierman here, authors of Core Confidence. Today we want to talk to you more about self-belief, but this piece of, you know, if you've ever been in a situation where you've doubted yourself, where you've made a decision and then you've second-guessed that decision, or whether you've been moving in a direction and all of a sudden you've received feedback or commentary from someone, perhaps who isn't as deep in the detail, and it's completely rattled you. You've kind of been caught off guard and your whole kind of center of gravity has really kind of been shaken, and you've left kind of doubting yourself in terms of what to do next. And I think this is a really important conversation for you, particularly when we think about sources of self-belief. Self-belief as a topic on some level is really quite ambiguous anyway. But I think when we start to dig into what are we relying on as sources of self-belief to really start to help us calibrate and then rely on who we are, what our strengths are, and how we show up in conversations.
Yes, this piece about what can I rely on and where do I get my inner sense of I'm okay, you know, my sense of self-belief comes from knowing myself really deeply. So we know there are a few things to look at here, and you know, we want to really understand our capabilities. What is it that we own and hold and can share with the world, and how can we go about that? And that requires a certain level of self-awareness, both your kind of external pieces, you know, your experience, the things you've done in your workplace, maybe your qualifications, maybe those things that you hold well, but also knowing yourself on the inside, you know, knowing how I'm going to react in certain situations, knowing the things that tend to throw me off. So how can I do things to prepare myself well? There's a whole world here where the more we know ourselves, the better resourced we are to deal with these things that can crack or can undermine our self-belief. And there's also a whole world here around the way in which we interact with external pieces of feedback and external sources of self-belief.
Yeah, I think the internal sources, that skill, capability, experience, and being really connected with that. It sounds really easy, but I know from the work that I've done coaching a stack of women that the more that we actually spend time, you know, crafting achievement statements, really building strong CVs that talk to their skill, capability, experience, the more that that self-belief increases. So I think there's an important piece that this isn't an automatic thing that just happens because you have qualifications or you go and study again. And I think that's the danger here around leveraging qualifications or experience as sole sources of self-belief. They're important, absolutely. Just as important is that internal awareness of understanding, you know, some of your other, you know, emotional intelligent characteristics, some of your other personal characteristics as well. If we talk about the external pieces, I think this can be a really tricky one. And sometimes external feedback can completely tear our self-belief down. If there's someone in our world who gives us feedback that's counter to, you know, that internal view that we're holding, particularly if there's someone more senior or someone we respect, it can all come down like a pack of cards. And so I think there's a really important conversation here around curating a really good team of people around you. You want the supporters, you also want the detractors as well. And of course, the trick here is with the detractors or the people who are giving you constructive feedback. And again, we want to hold it in that way. It's how do you hold yourself so that you can take it objectively, that you don't take it personally, and you can take the information from that feedback, curate it, calibrate it in so that it's really useful and overall helps you to lift up and strengthen your game as well. So I think it's about calibrating feedback, good and negative feedback, and integrating that with the internal sense of self.
Yeah, there's so much good intel from others when we are discerning. And this is the piece here, is the more discerning we are, the more we can lean into and learn from the things that are valuable. And as you say, you know, we may not be comfortable here. I know myself, you know, I've had some great feedback from colleagues and, you know, partners and other facilitators and people I've worked with. And it hasn't necessarily been comfortable to hear that my tone was a bit off or the way I said something landed a bit awkwardly. And I'm so grateful that people were prepared to do that. I mean, you gave me one the other day. You said, oh, Fee, you know, you do that too much. And it's like, oh, thank you. Now I've caught that. Okay, now I can try. I'm not going to get it perfect, but at least I'm now conscious of it. And I can do something differently because I've got that piece of intel. The place to not get caught here is the really negative stuff that's actually about taking you down as a person. That's the stuff you need to really have good boundaries around and be able to say, hey, that's not for me at this time. You know, if you've got someone who's constantly looking to undermine you, that's not constructive. And we need to put that in a separate place and go, nah, that is actually something that we've heard time and again can really erode self-belief. So let's stop listening to the non-constructive feedback and find ways to really tap into the stuff that's actually valuable to us. And I think, you know, this leads into, well, what is it that I'm going to, you know, what is it that I can do differently? You know, what's available to me right now? And the first piece, you know, we often talk about is self-awareness. The more I understand myself, the more I get aware of what's going on with me, the more I can tap into my inner resources, the easier this is going to be going forward. And, you know, obviously from our point of view and the research we've done, you know, one of the most powerful inner resources you have is your core confidence. And the more you get in good contact with that, and the more you can rely on that, no matter what's coming at you or what's happening externally, the more you're able to recalibrate, as you're saying, the more you're able to show up and to not be, you know, completely decimated or fall over just because something goes wrong or something didn't turn out the way it had planned or you get some criticism.
Yeah, I think it's an important one here. This isn't something you have or don't have. This is something you build on, grow on. You and I continue to, you know, strengthen, and we practice what we preach very much in this space as well. But yeah, no question, self-awareness. Do not underestimate the assumption that we know our skill, capability, experience is flawed. Do the work to be able to, you know, articulate your experience and achievements really well. Understand your skills. It's more than buzzwords. It's deep language and communication around what your capabilities are. When I'm talking with clients, it's always around what value do you add, what problems do you solve. That's what we talk about, building really strong CVs. So I think that's a really important one. Curating a network of mentors, peers who you can secure really good feedback that you can trust, that you know will be constructive, is another really good tool in this space in terms of rounding out that kind of external feedback that you're going and that you're getting, and actually being able to collaborate that in to your overall sense of self. And I think the final piece here that's really important, and we, you know, it'd be nuts for us not to mention it, is, you know, you can do all that and there still will be moments of self-doubt, right? We're human after all. And so I think there's a really important piece of, you know, understanding that that will be present and have the courage and the resilience to move through anyway. Not, you know, waiting for that 100% unshakable, unbreakable confidence, not waiting to feel confident, knowing that there will be times where you will feel a little bit rocky, but actually, you know, moving through that. And what we know is the act of confidence comes for the feeling of confidence before the feeling of confidence, right? And so the feedback you get will reinforce that sense of self-belief and that core confidence.
Yes, yeah. I think, you know, the more we can get in touch with this, the more time we can spend, you know, checking ourselves, questioning what's going on, why, how am I doing this, and how can I make sure that I'm in good contact with my inner resources and that I'm getting good feedback, the stronger it will be in terms of how we show up and how we're not getting derailed or sidetracked by things that are really not serving us. That's, I think, the opportunity here.
Yeah, lots in the core confidence book about this, you know, ask for help, face fear, maintain resilience. I think on some level you could, confidence and self-belief are really deeply connected, and that's something we've been, you know, exploring a lot in the last year. So if you've loved today's Facebook Live, please share it with your network. If you've got a question, send us a comment below in the chat feed, or feel free to get in touch. And if you want to go deeper with your relationship with core confidence, visit our website, coreconfidence.com.au.